Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mangs, and I welcome you guys to the start of the long-awaited Fire Emblem Fates Birthright playthrough. My name is Mangs, as I said, and I am joined here by the one, the only...
Hello.
Grima.
That's never getting old for me.
We're gonna do an entire LP with that voice. That's gonna be extremely good. So yeah, this is my good friend Ray.
How's it going?
And he's gonna be joining me here
for sick this Birthright strat. Here
yeah.
we go.
Yeah, and of course we're gonna be playing on Lunatic, blind. This is gonna be fun. The reason why I'm doing this is because a new DLC is available from the Dragon's Gate. Oh.
That's last week's DLC. That's updated now.
Pay to win. So yeah, I'm going to be playing on Lunatic. So what I actually have done here, right, Ray, is that I've actually played this chapter in advance just to prepare myself. But I'll still play it on screen. So I made two different save files right here. So as you can see, it's Birthright Lunatic Classic.
Yeah, I see it.
The reason why I really wanted to play Lunatic was because I've gotten a lot of rewards from the castle, and I felt really bad about gimping myself. So I thought, maybe if I just play Lunatic, I can use those rewards. Although, from what I've heard, Lunatic isn't that, like, it's not as brutal on Birthright as it is on Conquest, I've heard.
Yeah, I've heard the same, that most of the areas aren't that much better in Lunatic. It's just mainly bosses, and even then it's just limited to extra skills, for the most part.
So yeah. So we will be starting. However, I will be skipping the introduction. If you want to see the introduction, you can go and watch my Conquest Let's Play, which is finished at this point. The reason why I'm skipping this as well as the cutscene is because Nintendo really likes to go after channels with that cutscene in the LP. They really don't like it, Ray, when you post that scene in your videos.
I don't.
They have some sort of automated feature to find that video, and they go after channels with that video in them. I don't know what Nintendo is doing, right? I really don't. Like, I'm promoting their game for free. Jesus Christ. So if you want to see the prologue, I won't be doing the prologue. You can click the link on the screen. You can go watch my Conquest Let's Play, which was the first Let's Play I did. This is the second one, so I'm a little bit more experienced in the ways of Fates right now. I'm not going to promise I'll be any good, but at least I know a little bit more about the game now. So, my family... So,
oh, no.
So right?
Who do you want to go for? Do you want to defend Hoshido, you know, the right side this entire time?
Well, I tried Nohr. I wasn't, it was fun,
that
but...
was a poor thing.
the story, oh my god. We have Revelations, or Relevations.
Buy our game.
But, Ray, where's the option to join Smash?
You have to beat Lunatic on all three difficulties.
Oh, then I get to join Smash. all right, cool.
This is your final boss is freaking Master Core.
So yeah, we will be doing Revelation eventually, but first we're gonna be doing Hoshido. Yes. So, I have never played this before, so I am really curious to see how the story is. I've heard it's a lot better than Conquest, although that shouldn't really take a lot of effort.
Sander, withdraw your troops.
Mangs, don't tell me you're siding with Hoshido.
I'm afraid so. I made up my mind. I stand with Hoshido.
I fear the Hoshidians might try... Ray, how do you say Hoshidians? Because it's Hoshido, but
Hoshidans.
Do you say... Hoshidians. Hoshidians. Okay, it's not Hoshidians. Alright.
I fear the Hoshidians might try to brainwash you. I am well aware of your Hoshidan lineage. It is true that we lack common blood, but still, we've treated you as kin since the very day you arrived in Nohr. No matter what anyone says, you are my brother, Mangs. I know that Camilla, Leo, and Elise feel the same way. And Father will forgive you, I know it.
Yeah, I know all about Garon's forgiveness and how much that's worth now.
Uncle Garon's gonna welcome you with open arms.
You are of Nohr. Return to us, Mangs. I'm sorry, I can't go back. King Garon is a coward and a liar. I witnessed enough of his destruction. Causing an explosion in a crowded city, center with no regard for innocent life? That's the action of a madman.
Wow, I instantly like Birthright Corrin a lot more now.
See? That's the most logical response any person would have. Any sane person would have. They see what Garon would be up to. They witness the death of not Emeryn here, and they'd be like, shit, my dad was fucked up. He did some really nasty shit. I don't want to be on your side anymore. I mean, you're my family, bro, but no.
Daddy issues, am I right? Mangs, my dear.
Tell me, King... If King Garon thinks of me as family, why would he have orchestrated this attack? I could have easily been killed along with Queen Mikoto. The truth is that I was just a pawn, collateral damage. King Garon was willing to sacrifice my life in pursuit of his agenda. Face it, Sander, Garon is no longer human. He's pure evil. Father, evil? How could you say that?
Shut up, Sander.
After playing Conquest, this just becomes so humorous. I'm not going to spoil anything in case the viewers haven't played Conquest yet, but holy shit.
Little Prince? Sander, please join me. Join me and help me put an end to this cruelty. Mangs, you know I can't do that until Revelations. There's my answer, traitor!
You hold Xander for the 90% of Hoshido. That's his entire MO. You're a traitor, brother. Traitor!
All he needs now is a stormtrooper uniform and he's good to go. Traitor, brother, wait.
Enough, I never thought I would try. You would turn your back on your kingdom and your family. Your betrayal will not be forgiven. You want to side with Hoshido? Fine. Over my dead body.
Sander? Snap, man. Ow! Come on. Jesus, calm down. Calm down. No. Jesus. A little help?
You got wrecked, son.
You have been deceived, brother. They've clearly brainwashed you. I will not rest until I've returned you to your senses. Get up. Get up and return to Nohr with me. Surely there's some part of you that still remembers your true family.
Brother, my mind is made up.
If that's the case, I will end this quickly.
Wait, a little help here? Oh, thanks, Dioma.
Shine Spark!
Oh, Dioma, you really need to get more strength. I've heard this guy's crazy good, Rang.
Oh, he's stupid good. Ryoma is easily the best unit in the entirety of Birthright. Wow. Hands down.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. Just try it, Norian scum! Oh, he said it, Ray! He said it!
Scum, the memes, Jack, they begin today.
Oh, I'm gonna miss Camilla and her Norian bum.
Ryoma, please, we can settle this peacefully. What's wrong, Mangs? Lost your focus? Tossing your sword aside and dying as a martyr won't do us any good.
Well, tell that to Takumi. You seek to take my brother from me. I won't go easy on you.
Oh, why don't you spare me the chit-chat? Shut up and attack if you dare. Splendid idea. I've yearned to introduce you to a dear friend of mine, the Darkblade Siegfried.
It's a Darkblade. Interesting. How will its divine lightning pierce the sky then, Ray?
Interesting question.
Camilla, Leo, Elise, are you ready?
Darling, I was born ready. Let's kill them all quickly so we can make it at home in time for Mangs to snap. Dude, Camilla, give it up.
You're coming with us. That's all there is to it. Understood, Mangs?
Yay, we're gonna take Mangs back home.
Wow, you're stupid.
Please. Mangs has made his choice.
Please.
All that remains is to spill your blood and wipe my divine sword clean. Hinoka, Takumi, Sakura, steal yourselves.
I'll be your shield, Mangs. They won't kidnap you again.
Stupid Norian jerks. I'll kill all of you.
Oh, talk to me.
My man.
I missed you.
I'm ready. I won't let them hurt you, Mangs.
Very well. All forces, attack! Warriors of Hoshido, prepare for battle.
All right. So it is time. Oh, hello.
We got trouble.
Hey, Felicia.
I made it, Lord Mangs. Is everything okay?
Felicia? No, we're far from okay. There's no time to explain right now. Your timing is terrible. What are you doing here right now?
How can you say that? I've been looking for you this whole time. Anyway, I'm here now. I'll stand by your side.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, so your team is unchanged from the Hoshidian side of things.
See, I've done this map before. We'll talk about the characters in the next map because there's so many of them right now. So I found that this map is ridiculously easy, even on Lunatic. Because you can pretty much just take the Oma down here. You can just fuck over Leo.
Yeah, that's pretty much how... What you're seeing right now is not an exaggeration. This is how good Ryoma is in the main game.
Holy shit.
If you attack, I will have no mercy. I hope you're prepared to die.
Like, oh my god, Ryoma is really fucking... Oh my...
Oops.
For the glory of Hoshido! That fucking boot every time.
I really like the fact that you can see all the soldiers in the background when you attack on the bridge. It's really cool.
Yeah, I thought that was kind of cute.
But it kind of gives me the sense that everyone's like standing back and letting the family duke it out, which is really weird. Like, what are they doing? I'm like, no, step back. We must let the royals fight. Like, no, that's a terrible idea. Why should we do that?
Lost my sense of illusion.
You're stronger than I expected.
Oh, poor Leo. All
right. Okay, Takumi. Oh, my God. I heard this guy is so fucking good.
B rank bow already. Cheers.
I can't wait to show you my casa. All right? It's going to be amazing. So, yeah, I'll just... I guess this map kind of ends if you clear up Xander, doesn't it?
Yes, it does, automatically. When yeah. Xander goes, the map's over.
Yeah, so I'll just quickly clear up these guys. You'll get to see my amazing Mangs in a very, very short while.
I look forward to the gracity that is Mangs again.
And yeah, I do believe you start with Aqua, don't you?
Yeah, Azura stays with you, and she doesn't go anywhere, so...
That's kind of cool. And also, doesn't all the healing, or all the healing staves in Hoshido, they have two ranged?
Yeah, the main healing staves are the Festal series, they're rods, and they're slightly weaker than the standard staves we've been used to, but they do have extra range for that nice little kickback stuff, shall we say.
Yeah, you can heal diagonally now, that's kind of cool. Alright, a level up that doesn't really matter, and we got trouble! No, we don't. We got too little damage. I gotta admit, though, right? I did something slightly deplorable in the tutorial.
I'm impressed. What did you do?
I did something that I think a lot of people will scream and bitch about.
What did you do, Mangs?
Well, you know, Aqua kind of sucked in my Conquest playthrough.
Oh,
I decided
no.
to
oh.
do something about that.
Oh, no.
So maybe now she won't instantly die to everything that comes her way. That's at least what I'm hoping. Also, I don't think Sandra can kill Takumi. No, he can't. 28 damage. Nope, we're good. Yeah, does he start out with this thing?
Yes, that never leaves him.
So he can just move through terrain. That's ridiculous. It's like...
Fojin YOLO, as I like to call it.
He's like Sturm in Advanced Wars. He just moves through terrain.
This is Sturm's predecessor.
It's ridiculous. Anyway.
The humble beginnings of the regal tyrant known only as Sturm.
Oh my God. What foolishness. I will not tolerate traitors in our midst. I've got you. So is he hard-coded to always go for the armor?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
And that's it.
Oh my God.
That's it.
Well, you'd think that this isn't much harder on Lunatic. I think this is pretty identical on all difficulties. How is this possible? We must retreat. This isn't over, Mangs. No, it's not over. Yay, one turn. Dundun and Mecha would be proud. Is this really our future? A lifetime of conflict with Nohr? Mangs, I can understand why you're reluctant to fight. If it would make you feel better, you can leave the fighting to me and Ryoma. Or just Ryoma.
Or just Ryoma.
No, burying my head in the sand won't change the reality of the situation. I will stand with you and the rest of Hoshido.
Very well.
I know this is the right choice. Even if it's the hardest one I've ever had to make, I have to believe this is the path that will eventually lead to peace. How nice. So I will just go straight into chapter 7 right now. I just wanted to include that introduction, even though it's... I guess most of you guys have seen it by now. Again, I would just like to say that if this is the first time you're watching my Let's Play, the reason why I'm skipping through is because I've already played Conquest, so I've seen all of this before. So again, I really...
see you are Derek Falcon there, Mangs. Well done.
Falcon! Punch! I am
you're
Dark
Falcon. Enjoy the shit out of the Dark Falcon skills for this one.
Yeah, so time to show you guys my team. So I made this base a couple of weeks back, I do believe. So some of you guys have already taken a sneak peek by visiting my castle. So I present to you guys Dark Falcon Mangs. Now, there is one mistake with this guy, right? I'm not sure if you can see it, but I fucked up.
Oh, I see it.
You see it?
I see it.
No Dragon Fang for me.
Yeah, no Dragon
Fang. I waited. He was literally 12 experience away from promoting, and he would have gotten Dragon Fang on level 10. But honestly, Ray, looking at his base stats, I don't think he needs it.
Dark Falcon is nuts, Clash.
You get so insane bonuses when you promote to Dark Falcon. And it's... I do believe it goes all the way up to 40, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. It's a standalone class, so it will go up to 40 as its natural level cap.
Yeah, so this is Mangs. I have given him a magic boon in this playthrough. So he will have a lot of magic, and I've given him a hit point bane. So he'll be a little bit squishy, but he has 30 hit points. I think I gave him an angelic orb from the rewards just to fix that a little bit. So yeah, he's going to have a shit ton of magic and speed. And oh boy, I can't wait until he gets fucking Gale Force Ray. That's going to be so insane. Oh.
Gale Force!
So we ain't going to have a Yato in this playthrough, but honestly, I don't think we need it. So it's going to be a lot of fun. So yeah, this is Mangs, everyone. Let's take a look at the rest of our team, shall we? I have decided to make Rinka a Dreadfighter.
She's a Dreadfighter. I noticed the map sprite right away.
So I don't really know much about the Dreadfighter class, but from what I understand, they get a lot of resistance.
Yeah, it's the same as the Demon Fighter class in Gaiden. Right. They get a lot of res. Yeah. And their basic skills do a lot of, are just basically a lot of attacking damage. Their last skill is Aggressor, which is plus seven damage when you make the first move.
Right. So Rinka, of course, has Fire Blood, so she does more damage when she's damaged. And she has Steel Resistance, which is kind of cool. I like that. She's going to be nice in combination with Mangs, I think. And she can use Swords, Axes, and Hidden Weapons. I mean, what the hell? That is ridiculous.
It's a pretty good loadout, I'm not going to front.
So
Especially the inclusion of Shuriken.
Yeah, and then I decided to give a couple of Dragon Herbs to the one and only Kaza! Look at his stats, Ray, look at his stats!
He's cap strength already!
This is excellent!
Kaza,
Kaza!
People really felt like I kind of did Kaza a lot of wrongdoings or something, I guess, in my last playthrough. You know, promoting him, kind of, you know, using him as, I don't know, a lot of people were pissed with me for not utilizing Kaza properly. So I decided that this playthrough, I will utilize him properly, and he's gonna be really fucking good. So, he has a lot of different weapons. He's the Sting Shuriken, he has the Hunter's Knife, he has the Kagura's Dart, Fruit Knife. He has a lot of good hidden weapons. I'm really looking forward to Kaza, and of course this. He basically has Miracle, which is kind of cool. I like that, even though I feel like it almost never saves you. Do you feel like it's good, Ray?
It's procced for me at least twice, I think.
Yeah, okay, well, it does save you a restart, so in that sense, it is a good skill, I guess. And of course, we got Trouble! Not much to say about Felicia, she's the same, she's always been. She's alright, though. I really like Felicia, although I've heard
that. Not a hero, bad unit out of 10.
But I've heard that Jacob is pretty good.
Yeah, the difference between the two is that Jacob's a little more bulkier, Felicia has more magic, so if you give her the Flame Shuriken, she'll start wrecking house as a maid.
Yeah, I don't believe she has the skill to use it yet, but I like Felicia. She has Devoted Partner, she's got a lot of good skills on her. And of course we got Aqua, who's level 19 now. Lol. So that means she got the Inspiring Song from the get-go. I decided if I'm going to play Lunatic, I'm going to play Lunatic right. And if the game allows me to do this kind of shit, I'm going to do it, okay? I'm not going to feel bad about that. So
why not?
If the game allows me to break it, I will break it, okay? Then put fucking mechanics in place to prevent me from breaking it, if that's so bad. But yeah, Aqua, she's going to be a lot better in this playthrough, I think, because now she can actually fight. And she has 14 death, which I really like. So she's not going to be... She still has 17 hit points, though, so she's still going to get one-shotted by some people. And then we have a character I don't know much about, but here's Sakura. I heard she's decent too.
She's actually pretty damn good. Notice that strength? It's gonna go up a lot.
Really?
Yeah, her strength growth is very high.
Interesting. Will that help her?
She has a class that uses physical weapons, so yes, it will.
Cool. I really like that. She has quiet strength, or allies within 2 paces. Okay, so that's good.
Plus that's 2 defense. That's a good passive. Yeah. I like it better than Elise's passive.
Yeah, Elise's passive gives a little bit of damage as well. And it has shorter range. So yeah, this is our first team. And I've decided, and this might be a little bit of an unpopular decision, I'm not going to do supports in this playthrough. Because I really like the supports, but there are so many of them. There are so many supports. So this is probably the last you're ever going to see of Fort Mangs in this playthrough. I am just going to do chapter by chapter in this playthrough. I'm not going to bother about doing any time-spacey base stuff. Because simply it takes up like 20 minutes each part, and I just want more gameplay. So we've spent 20 minutes introducing, but it's part one, so that should be a given. So let us, Ray, jump into chapter 7, A Wow Upheld. After siding with the Hoshidians and facing off against the Norian royals, well, after Ryoma kicked the shit out of all the Norian royals, you mean?
Accurate description.
Mangs and company make their way to Fort Jinja to help tend the wounded. Oh, this is one of the endgame chapters in...
Yeah, it's one of the first map you meet here in Birthright.
Cool.
Chapter 7, A Vow Upheld.
Mm-hmm. There's like sakura flowers everywhere. I like that. I wonder if it's going to be the same map even. Kingdom of Hoshido. Fort... Why can't they just call it Fort Ninja? Come on.
Fort Ninja.
We all know what's in there.
Don't talk about Fort Ninja just yet.
This way, Mangs. What is this place? This is Fort Ninja. It's Fort Ninja from now on. Sakura is already here, tending to the wounded soldiers and citizens. Let's go and help her. By all means. Oh, Mangs, looking sassy in that dark falcon outfit.
She's like, yeah, I'm the fucking best right now.
Hello. Oh.
Introductory cutscene.
Mangs, thank you for coming.
Is everything okay, Sakura? I'm here to help.
Yes, but thank goodness you're here. We're really short-staffed.
Hello, Lord Mangs. I'm Hana. Lady Sakura's told me all about you.
Oh, I killed you once. Hey, I killed you too.
I know all these characters because I killed them all in Conquest.
Sweet.
This guy was annoying. It was really hard to hit.
And I'm Tsubaki. It's a pleasure to meet you, Lord Mangs.
Nice to meet you both. I'm afraid you probably know a lot more about me than I know about either of you.
That's okay, Mangs. I'm sure you'll be fast friends in no time. Hana and Tsubaki are my retainers, always close at hand and ready to help.
Oh, I see. Well, we should have plenty of time to relax and get to know.
Mangs, we got trouble!
I couldn't Felicia have someone. Seriously, we haven't been here in 5 minutes.
Yeah, well, all the Norian soldiers have wasted... The Norian soldiers haven't wasted any time surrounding us.
Unbelievable.
Guys. Waste this time already? Come on, we're building. We gotta have some of this.
Oh, why can't the Norians be nice to us in this war?
I wonder why.
I can't believe they'd attack at a time like this. We're using most of the fort as a makeshift hospital. There's no military target here. Why can't they just leave us alone?
Don't worry, milady. I can handle this.
With my help, of course. If you'd like, Lady Sakura, you may remain with the wounded while we resolve this.
I'll consider it. Thank you, both of you.
Well then, I guess we'll be getting to know each other in a hurry. Nothing like a life or death situation to cut right through the small talk.
As you command, Lord Mangs. As Lady Sakura's lead retainer, it will be my pleasure to take your orders.
And as Lady Sakura's supervising retainer, I too welcome your leadership.
Okay, one of them is the lead retainer, and the other one's the supervisor retainer?
Keep reading.
Okay. Alright, supervising retainer, that's not a thing. Well, neither is the lead retainer. I don't remember you getting a promotion.
Lady Sakura and I have been best friends since childhood. I've always been her lead retainer.
I'm not sure this is a time or place for such a discussion, but I believe my results on the battlefield speaks for themselves.
Establishing character moments.
Oh, so that is why you neglect all your known battle duties? Is that why I'm the one maintaining all our gear and scouting the enemy?
Guys,
knock it off, you two! You're embarrassing yourselves and me! Mangs, please don't let this juvenile display deceive you. Hana and Tsubaki are both extremely capable on the battlefield. They're both going to set aside this petty argument and help you, right?
Of course, milady.
Certainly, expect perfection and you will not be disappointed.
Excellent, I'm glad to have your support.
We should get moving and face the intruders head on. We must protect our wounded.
Of course.
All right.
Oh, gosh.
Mm-hmm. All right. It's a Forta Jinja. And here we are. Whew. Okay. So this is the first map of Birthright. Looks fairly wow, it's actually for a first map. This is actually pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of...
It's easily very straightforward. The boss is familiar.
No! Hey, Silas! Oh, can I recruit him? Can I recruit him? I'm not gonna be able to recruit him. Oh, Silas!
Damn, fucking B rank, weapon ranks already. This really is freaking lunatic mode.
Oh my god! Hello. Oh man, I miss you. I really like Silas. I have to kill him in the first. Aw, this is sad. Wow, holy shit! There's a lot of enemies here. Are there more enemies on Lunatic Raid? Do you know that?
No, from what it looks from where I'm standing, the enemy loadout seems to be the same.
There's not a lot of skills. There's not a lot of skills here at all. I don't see any skills, actually. At all. Nope, not a single.
Birthright was very sparse in skills, even on hard mode, so, I'm always surprised if there were Lex and Lunatic as well. It's just a lot of the guys have B rank weaponry now instead of C.
All right, so we got Hana right here. Does she join us in this map, Ray, or is she just...
Yeah, she's auto-fielded, as you can see.
All right. So, yeah, why don't you tell me about Hana?
Hana's basically pretty much a glass cannon. She's got some pretty deep, good strength skill and speed, but her HP and defense are pretty low. She's decent res. Her personal skill, Fleet Fearsome Blow, does damage. She managed to kill an adjacent enemy, and dudes that are also adjacent to her will also take damage as well.
Okay.
So she's in the thick of it. She can do a lot of damage as well. She can also do this to do damage to a dude that she just got beating from a paired up dude.
Oh, really? Cool. That's nice. All right. What about Tsubaki? What do you think about this guy?
I like Tsubaki a lot, not just because of the fact that he's a male peg. His stats are only, like, okay, despite the fact that he claims that he's a perfectionist. Mm-hmm. His personal skill is perfectionist, which is kind of cool. Plus 50 hit and evasion while he's at full HP.
Cool.
His stats are alright for the most part. He's just a little bit slow and lacking in the strength department, but he has some pretty nice skill and speed, or skill and defense, although which is otherwise lacking in most of the other Pegasus Knights.
And this is a really good skill, right?
Darting blow will just help offset his alien speed on the whenever he makes the initial attack.
Hmm.
But he kind of needs the speed in order to stay relatively good.
Yeah. Sounds cool. Sounds cool. Seems like I can't change their position though. That kind of sucks.
Yeah. This is they're auto fielded. You can't do anything about them.
Nope. All right. Well, I will be swapping. And we need to go and get this chest, but I really want to send Kasa over here and murder this guy with the Sting Shuriken.
He's dead. He's so fucked.
Oh, yeah. Well, all right, let's see what Lunatic has to offer. I am really looking forward to this. All right. Oh, Mangs, is that really you? Who's asking? Yeah, that's the voice I remember. How do they even hear each other, right? I never understood.
I'm talking to you from halfway across the map, Mangs. I'm so glad to see you, my bestie.
That really is the voice I remember. It is really you. Please drop the act. We don't know each other. You honestly don't remember? It's me, Silas. We were best friends as children. I don't remember that much, I'm afraid. Mangs, be careful. This could be a trap of some sort. I promise I'm telling the truth. However, it may seem like we're destined to clash or regardless of our past. Okay. Well, I was... Compared to the recruitment conversation he had, wow, that was short compared to Conquests. Holy shit. Alright. I'm just gonna have to fucking check.
That's good.
Oh my god, what the hell? Oh shit, okay, this guy's an Iron Axe. You know what, right? It doesn't fucking matter what they have. Oh, oops, animations.
Yeah, the expected result.
Oh my god. Okay, so what's this? Reveal a healing area. Oh my god, so there are healing areas. I was wondering where those went.
Yeah, they're most of them in just this one related to Birthright. But yeah, that's what it is.
All right.
There's another one in the room below you as well.
I see. So I'm going to go and get that chest, I think. And then I am, my guys are really strong. Like, really fucking strong.
Gee, you don't say.
That's an archer. That archer will still fuck over Mangs, I'm afraid. But no, actually, no. What? Why are they so slow? Oh, they don't move! Okay.
Yeah, those are since they're on guard position, they're not gonna move.
Right. Alright, that's, I really gotta say, I like how the map tells me these guys are not gonna move. I really appreciate the hell out of that, I gotta say.
Yeah, good mechanics are good mechanics.
And I gotta say,
can't
fault
that.
I have, oh, what's this? We have some javelins. Ooh, I could have abused the shit out of that with Kasa. Oh well. I've gotten a lot better at, like, pairing up. Like, what... The thing about pair-ups is... It's not so much that you get the extra attacks and shit, but it's the extra mobility you get. Like, I can pair up a unit, like, here. And then I can move him over here, pair him up with someone else. And you can literally, like, pair up a unit halfway across the map. Like, it's ridiculous how strong it is. Don't know, it would be so fun
it's
to see what...
It's insane how absolutely mobile pair-up makes you strong. That's the reason why I don't use it.
Yeah, that's right. You actually don't use pair-ups, which is kind of funny. So yeah, it looks like we have ourselves a really choky choke points right here. And Mangs doesn't seem to be in a fantastic position to deal with it. But what I can do is I can use Rinka, I guess. Rinka paired up with Sakura, probably. I could also use the healing thing, I don't know. So we'll try... Well, I really like the fact that I have Inspiring Song. So then I can give crazy, like, 16 speed, what the hell? And then I guess we could use the katana, I don't know. Wow, these guys don't do a lot of damage at all. Wait, what? Oh no, Raider Knife, never mind. I think what I'll do is I'll use the Raider Katana, but that's a lot of damage. I could just stand still, I suppose. I think I'll just stand still. There we go. And I'm going to show everyone the
accurate.
Oh my god, Mangs is so fucking strong. I think it's probably better to let Hanan get the kill. This is the problem with having a really strong avatar. You can't really use him to, you know, give others experience, I suppose. That kind of sucks. Anyway, let's... I really don't like the different spirits. I feel like they look a little bit weird. Like, I'm throwing sheep at the guy.
So what's wrong with throwing sheep at the people so bad? What's wrong with throwing sheep at someone?
I don't know, it just feels a little weird.
It's Hoshidian magic, you can't fool Hoshidian magic, it's good shit.
I suppose. Alright. Yeah, I really, really enjoy just moving people around on the map. It's a lot of fun. Alright. So, okay, this is good. Rinka won't... Ow. Crap. Rinka won't kill the guy, that's good. Why is, like... What the hell happened there? He's naked.
Oh, his clothes are gone, because you use a raider weapon.
Oh, right! Is there, like, any... Like, it's just visually, right? It doesn't do anything.
I think so. I'm pretty sure it's just visual, although I think there is a chance that you might get some of the armaments they fall off as accessories, I think. I don't know. I never bothered with the accessories. Just
really?
I didn't have the time, but I think that might be it.
Huh. Okay. Anyway, I gotta kill this guy. I was thinking... I really like how you, like, seal resistance from beyond the wall. It's a really cool skill to have. One skill that I never got access to in Nohr was Seal Defense, but I do believe you get it in Hoshido.
Yes, this is a Spear Fighter class, and luckily you have one such character who is very good, and one of my favorite characters, by the way.
Is that,
you can use such a skill.
Is that Obito?
Yes.
Because I remember killing Obito in Conquest, and people didn't like that.
She's actually my favorite character, and she's really good.
I see. Okay. So, the question is, can Rinka freaking tank this hallway? I don't think she can. Maybe with a club. But if... I'll need to give her some healing, though. I could use the Raider Knife, and I'll be able to... Oh my god, look at this shit. Holy crap. Hello. I'm gonna train your hidden weapons.
Taste my hidden knife. This is a knife.
More fuel for the fire. Oh, I really like the... I really like the sprite of the Dreadfighter. They look pretty fucking cool. I know, Felicia. Okay, you're gonna... Oh, that's right. I got Sun Festivals now. I can heal from range.
Yeah, you're gonna have to get used to that now.
I am not gonna get used to that. I did have access to these festivals a little bit in Conquest, but they were pretty scarce, so I really, like, tried hard not to to overuse them. Here's what I can do, is I can place Mangs here, as long as I kill this archer on the next turn, which shouldn't be that hard. What I can do is I can dance for Rinka. It's so nice to have an Aqua that doesn't, like, die when someone farts in her general direction. I really gotta say that, like... And then I can kill this guy, and then I can kill the archer. Haha, you're naked. You kinda take... Oh, what the... Oh my god, that looked cool. She literally... teleported back and forth. What the hell?
It's a ninja. What a ninja to do? Anything else?
Teleport back and forth.
Only 10 fucking damage. Get out of here.
Yeah, I'm just... I gotta try and kill him. 18 plus 3, 18 plus 6. I think I should... If I trade to a more robust weapon... what is good against bows against Ray? Is it swords?
I barely remember much of the new open triangle. I think it was swords, though.
I think it's swords, because if I do that... there we go, 16 plus 6.
Yeah, it is.
I do think that weapon triangle is linked to weapon rank now, just like it was in Awakening. I'm pretty sure.
Thank you.
The bonuses? Yes, it is.
So, you want to have... But holy crap, it takes a long time to grind weapon rank up in this game.
It is. It
nice
does.
Level up.
It does.
Even keel? What the hell is that?
This unit receives -4 magic damage on even number turns.
Oh, cool. All right. For those who manage to keep track of such things, I guess that is a nice thing to have. Yeah, okay, we got Kaos over here. Wow, this map is like 4 choke points.
This was the case back when I was playing on hard mode as well. It was literally 4 choke points.
I mean, if you have a lot of enemies charging you and you put a choke point there, then this is what's going to happen, game developers. I mean, it doesn't look like it's going to get any better either. That's a lot of units, Ray.
Yeah, that's a lot of units coming out for you.
Oh like, my god, what the hell? Alright, so we have a bow right here, 13 damage. We have a javelin, but this guy doesn't move, I think. Nope.
That guy does not move.
But the archer moves, so maybe we can just snipe him with Kaza. We'll use the... what does the most damage? Hunter's knife actually does a lot of... What is the thing about Kagato's Darch? Do you know?
You can see right there, it gives you a massive avoid boost, and its bonuses are... And its bonuses, I believe, you pass over it, gives a -5 skill when you hit an enemy.
I can see it here. Okay, that is really cool. That's what it does. Okay. I was not aware. Okay, cool. Let's see. I think the hunter's knife is actually really good. Huh. We'll use the hunter's knife then. That seems to be what's doing the most damage. Alright, I guess I'll just fucking ravage these guys. I guess I should try and give some kills to the other guys as well, I suppose.
You probably should. They're gonna be in your party. This is not gonna be a solo act.
Fucking the Dread Fighter is so cool. I love it. Yeah, this is what I really hate about Pyrrhus Rang. Like, now I'm kind of like stuck with Sakura there, and I have to like spend a turn to get her out. Although I could always rescue her with someone else, I suppose. Let's see. I guess we can just use. Okay, there's a fucking archer right there. I feel like Kana gets wrecked by these guys.
She probably will. Again, she's a glass cannon for the most part. She'll do damage, but if she gets breathed on, she's probably going down.
Yeah, so I think I'll use the Sun Festival to heal up, and I think maybe what I'll do is I'll switch over to Mangs, maybe? I think so. I think we'll transfer like so. No, wait, that's not going to help. I want to do it the other way around. Let's see. I want to transfer Sakura away. Then I want to switch. Oh, that doesn't work.
I'm so good at utilizing the pair-up mechanics of this game, Ray.
That's fine. Sakura can stay with Mangs. Here, have a horse. Have another horse. Kind of doesn't fit the Dark Falcon gimmick, though. Throwing horses at people? I don't know. Feels a little weird. Okay, I can't kill that guy. Oh crap, Mangs is in range of the archer now, but I don't think it's gonna matter, to be quite honest.
Yeah, that doesn't move, so don't worry.
The Raider knife. Nah, let's use the brass club. Yep.
Going clubbing.
I really wonder why they I feel like just two weapons would have been fine for the Dread Fighter. I don't know why they felt the need to give them three. Feels a little bit weird, if you ask me.
That's what they did with Awakening Dread Fighters, Sword Axe, Magic.
Ah, I see. Oh. Oh, what's this? Hello, my name's Kasa. I throw shurikens through walls. And you are now dead. I'll make sure to promote you this time around, good friend. Let's have fun. Ooh. Yep. The Dread Fighter moves so erratically. It's like, now I'm here. Oh my god, look, oh my fucking god, right, like, this is not good map design,
look at this.
This is just, like, I don't want to move from this position, thank you very much. I'll just stay around here.
That's the dragon vein.
I guess I'll do the dragon vein. I guess. Yeah. This isn't good map design, right? Like, I understand what they were going for right here, and I really like fort-type maps. Also, I should really stop just spamming staves. This is a thing I can't stop doing, right? Just spamming staves for experience. I do it all the time.
I do it all the time too, and I'm not sorry either. So don't worry about that, Mangs.
All right, Gasp, you were so angry with me when I did that. You're like, can't have your staves, Mangs.
You can get away with a lot more in this one though, since this is Birthright. Yep. You have more freedom with your items. Anyway, the Kaze stream continues.
Kamikaze! I guess that no one has ever made that joke before.
Kamikaze. Fuck.
Hey, thanks. 500 gold. Alright, time for Brinka to take a lot of damage. She's gonna get a shield now, so that's fine. I am actually pushing her a little bit here. But what's great about her is that she's not really gonna kill them. So the amount of attacks she will take is pretty... Wow, okay. That's really good, actually. Well, I guess I can start picking... I think what I'll do is I'll transfer and I'll separate, like so. I'll place Felicia right here. Heal up. And then I can actually go ham with Mangs. Just try to... Hello! What should we kill them with? Should we kill them with a horse, a monkey, or a sheep, Ray? Or the moon?
Give him the monkey. Give him the monkey.
All right. I'm a monkey spirit!
Shall we?
Give him the whole hoo-ha!
Yes, I did it right, Mangs.
Alright.
Yes, I did it right!
You did it right, Mangs. Good job. Alright, so the question is now, do I... It's a lot of damage she's gonna take on this face. I'm not really sure if I like it. I also want to dance with... She will have the shield, though. She used the katana. She won't kill him, sadly, but she will with the axe. There's a lot of spear-wielding enemies, so I think maybe the axe would be good. But I feel like even Rinka, as bulky as she is probably going to get a little bit owned. So I'm going to move Aqua back here. And risk a knife it. Because hidden weapons are ridiculously good, and I want her to get hidden weapon ranks. I feel like hidden weapons, perhaps, like, they're sort of like what the hand axe and javelin never became, you know? I feel like...
Yeah, I've had a discussion with my buddy Ether. Yeah? He's under the very, very firm impression that shurikens are pretty much universally the best weapon type in the entirety of Fates. They're a reliable 1-2 range physical weapon has very good damage. They do debuff effects. And they have a lot of other things that just make them universally well suited to counter, and they're anti-mage weapons as well.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, sure, their might is not fantastic, but, you know, it doesn't really matter all that much, to be quite honest.
And it helps that shuriken weaponry bonuses are might, just might, so if you get better with using shurikens, you're gonna do more damage.
Yep, pretty much. So yeah, I definitely feel like I didn't really utilize a lot of hidden weapons in my Conquest playthrough because I didn't use Kaze, so I didn't really get to use them all that much, but holy fuck, they are good. Jesus. Also, I feel like I'm using Rinka a lot here, but she is really the only one who can take all this abuse on enemy face, so... I don't want to die. I like dying, right? I think dying is kind of boring. Yep.
Death is no fun.
So yeah, Fort Ninja is apparently all about choking the points. I think... do we dare to move in here? I think we do. Again, I'm gonna spam staves because I'm an experienced whore. And we shall throw the moon at this guy, I think. Here.
Moon, shine down!
Can't fight the moonlight!
Moon, shine down!
It's over.
There we go. When do I get Gale Force, Ray?
Gale Force, I believe, is a level 35 skill. Aww. For Dark Falcon.
That's like forever. That sucks.
Sorry.
But, you know, I get that. I get that. Gale Force is ridiculous. Holy crap, stripping all them dudes nude. So yeah, we're choking. Oh, what? No! 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 Thief! Thief! He's going for the treasure chest!
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's actually happening. Okay, then
a mechanic you complained about that was lacking in Conquest is actually happening
here. It was, though. I don't think it happened a single time, right? I don't think it's single thief actually went for the treasure chests. Hello. Hey, I gave Hana a kill.
Asan Shop.
Oh, I like you. Okay, so I think we utilize a Dark Fatch on Mangs right here. Or maybe we... You know, I feel like I should use Tsubaki a little bit too, but that's an archer, and archers are scary.
Yeah, so, and they are allowed to switch if you put them next to them.
Yeah,
so,
they are, aren't they? Okay, well, what we can do is we can use the Kaza. Oh my god. Oh. Hello.
14th candle.
Yeah. Oh, I understood why you fucking love this guy so much, right? Holy.
He's so good. Ron and I adore him. Freaking, we love Kaze.
Yeah. I did read up on one thing. And I'm not gonna spoil it, but I have almost an A rank support with Kaze. I've heard that is important.
Yes, it is important. By a certain chapter, you have to have a A rank support with Kaze. Otherwise, something's gonna happen.
Yeah, some people warned me about that. I got a message saying, "Mangs, like, you have to read this. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but get an A rank support with Kaze." And I was like, "Okay, I take it that's very important then." So yeah, I'm looking forward to see what happens. All right, so let's use Kaze to start just because I can. Although, I probably should have moved Mangs this turn, come to think of it. If I want to catch up to that thief. Sorry, guys, I'm sick. not ideal time to record, I am aware. But, hey, that's, yeah. When I'm sick, I want to do Let's Plays even more when I'm sick, because I'm bored, so. Alright, so let's get... I don't know why I did that. I just really like transferring. Okay, we gotta capture that guy, right? We gotta fucking capture that guy. But I think we will be able to. Yes, we will. Dark Fatchon! In addition to having insane movement range, I also decided to give Mang some boots.
Of course. The most logical option.
Because...
End movement. Here we go.
Yep. So, I'm pretty sure I can move in with Aqua like so. And then, actually, that might have been a little bit stupid, now that I think about it. Ouch. No, you know what? She's just 14 defense. These guys do 1 damage to her. This guy does 5. Never mind. Aqua is completely fine.
Azura's just feel like, I am the ocean's Grayplex. Who will be lost in thoughts all alone upon your wares.
Oh my god. I am the ocean's Gray Rock. Like, she is... She... Wow, 1 experience. Good job, Mangs. Well, hey. Got the 1,000 gold. Lovely. I'm just gonna make sure we don't get owned by these archers right here. Let's move down here. I guess I could position Felicia here. She can take 1 hit from the guy. Because doesn't... No, wait. Demoiselle doesn't work for Aqua, does it? No, it doesn't.
Nah. Unless she's hiding something we don't know.
That would be awesome. Like, that would actually be really fucking cool. Alright, here we go. What the? What is this? Aqua actually being useful? Ugh, it's fine. Like, what is that robe made of, I wonder?
that bear look on her face says it all. He's like, yeah, whatever.
Oh my god. Perfect time. Oh my god, Gray, I'm gonna have to kill Silas. Man.
I know. I'm sorry. This is the choice of having to make a choice. Sometimes you have to let stuff go.
Holy shit. There's just... You know, Ray, I feel kind of dirty now.
How do you think I felt going from playing Birthright to Conquest? Because I'm gonna say something here. I said this before when I was talking with Mel, and I actually legitimately like all of the Birthright cast. Like, there's not a single character that I don't dislike or outright hate. I assume the children characters, of course, but that's another thing. You can kill a fish. But yeah, legitimately, the standalone Birthright cast, all of them are likable in their own respects, or at the very least, they're tolerable. Mm-hmm. And that's very, very rare for me in a Fire Emblem game. There's usually at least 1 character I don't like.
Do you feel that way about Conquest, though?
No, there are a few characters that I don't like in Conquest, named like Perry. I think her gimmick is ridiculous. But,
Perry, you mean the I like to kill people and bait in their blood gimmick?
Yeah.
How could you not like that?
there's another character like that in Birthright who is like that, but is a lot more subtle about it. Is a lot more strained and it's a lot better about it.
Okay.
We'll see her in time.
Looking forward to it. I'll back you up. Yep. Hello. Oh, nice one. You help me grow So yeah, a lot of people have been asking me to do a straw poll. I'm not gonna do that because honestly, I know a lot of people want to influence the kind of characters I'm using, but when I play a game for the first time, I just want to use the characters I like. You know?
Same with me.
So if there's like a character that I really like, I don't want to feel like really like limited in my options, you know? I understand a lot of you guys really like a couple of characters. Truth be told, I'm probably gonna play with most of the characters that are join early, because I really like availability. I don't like characters that join like on chapter 18, unless they're really good pre-promotes.
Yeah. You need to get a few of those in Birthright.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I've heard that the Birthright Royals are so much stronger than the Norian Royals.
So this is a fact.
So I'm really looking
this
forward.
This is a fact. I'm not attempt to hide. This is a fact.
Although, like, people did complain about me, like, not utilizing the Norian Royals at all in my Conquest Let's Play, and I do actually admit, I think I got really fucking screwed. I'll back you up. Because my Sandra was bad, my Leo was bad. Elias was really the only one who was good. So, and my Arthur and Effie just freaking went through the roof. I think I just got really lucky. People are like, oh, Mangs, Nyx is bad. Fuck you guys. Nyx is good. Alright, they move. Oh my god. And he has a javelin. Oh. Hey, wait a minute. Does this give him extra damage when Mangs is below half health?
That'd be fucking awesome if it did.
Wow.
I don't think so, though.
That's some wow of friendship right there. Alright, so Silas, he's slightly nasty, and Mangs is all the way up here, but let's see what's in this chest. Armor Slayer. I already have like 3 of those, but it's fine.
Armor Slayer, this is okay.
I guess I can forge someone. Alright, I think the most logical choice would be to simply tank this choke point right here. I think that's what I'm gonna do.
Yeah, Layman come to you would probably be the smartest decision here. That's what I did.
Yep. We got trouble. I really love how the maids like kick up the daggers from their boots, though.
That's classy. I don't see it that often because I always ever since I started playing Conquest, I just made Felicia a hero. That's it.
Yeah, I've heard that Felicia as a hero and Jacob as a butler is really powerful.
Jacob as a
great knight. I mean. You get like a really good Jagan. Skill luck defense. Live to serve. Awesome.
I live to serve.
Yes. Alright, so we're gonna be healing you up now. I find myself often with Aqua, I find myself dancing to get the boost of stats more than I actually get the extra turn.
Same.
Because like now I'm gonna place Rinka on the choke point. I guess I could dance. Actually I could probably do that if she can kill this guy in one turn, which she cannot. So yeah, now I'm just gonna position her here, and then I'm gonna dance. Yeah. She's gonna be fine. Hidden weapons, OP! And first level up for Rinka. I don't really know if Rinka's a good character or not. Did you use her, Ray? Nice one.
The main thing about Rinka is that she doesn't have a lot of strength, but she is pretty bulky, and she has a lot of defense. Her HP is a little low at the start, but I think everyone's is, but...
Everyone has low hit points in this game, except for Arthur.
But, yeah, that's just it, though. She is very bulky, and she has to get around her lack of strength hump first before she's any viable of usage.
Oh my god, this is a really kick-ass team.
Boss battle!
Wow, I really like the Hoshidian boss battle so much more awesome than the Norian one.
It's really good.
Don't take this personally, I'm just following orders from King Garon. Wow, he's Conquest, Corin.
Sweet.
Yeah. I gotta say though, right, out of all the weapons in this game, the javelin looks so ugly. Holy crap.
The
what
so
were
scary.
They thinking? What
it's
were
like
they
it's
thinking?
Like we're playing, it's like we're playing American Gladiators.
Look, just look at that thing. You wouldn't be you wouldn't be able to throw that 5 feet. Because it would just... The balance would be so off. It is pretty much the ugliest weapon I have ever seen in Fire Emblem history. And that says a lot. Anyway, so I think... Maybe we should try and give Hana the kill. Just, or maybe Tsubaki, I don't know. I feel like Tsubaki is a character that will become very good eventually, so let's give him the kill. Yeah, let's give him the kill. Or maybe, does the map end when you kill Silas?
Yes.
Oh, fuck. It doesn't matter though. It didn't have to be this way! You could have bought Conquest! No, it doesn't. Whee! Oh. Ugh, okay, that's not good. Iron Lens, let's do this. Let's just get some shameless, let's get some shameless healing staff experience, because I am, shameless like that. Yeah, you guys can stay up there and develop your support. But I gotta say though, right, the Norian generics look so fucking cool.
I legitimately like all the class designs in this game much better than I do Awakenings. By a long shot.
But the Norian generics looks like they're from the freaking Roman Empire.
I knew that tickled your fancy bone.
Oh my god, I love the fucking Romans, and oh, they look so cool. Alright, let's see. 97% single RNG, no thanks. No thanks. Not after what happened to Nefni.
Swung.
And don't you dare mention safety word, Ray.
I'm not fucking drinking that ever again. Ever again.
Oh man. Chapter 7 in 13 turns. 13. Alright. Go on. Kill me. No, this isn't right. What are you waiting for? You seem so hesitant to attack us, even as you led your army into battle. Why were you holding back? Because we were friends? Aren't you here on King Garen's orders? Did you even intend to defeat us? Mangs, some things are more important than following orders. You're going to need to be clearer than that, or I will finish you off. Do as you must. I value an oath I made long ago, far more than my own life. Still can't believe you don't remember. We used to play together. You always said how badly you wanted to see the world. So one day I made us a picnic and snuck you out for a few hours to explore. I even packed your favorite meal, surf and turf. What is surf and turf, Ray?
I don't know about surf and turf either. I don't know much about it.
Probably it's a sandwich or some sort. I don't know. I have to Google that. I knew taking you beyond the walls were forbidden, but I also knew how much it would mean to you. The guards tried to execute me when we returned, but you wouldn't let them do it. Gods, that does ring a bell. My life belongs to you, friend. Do as you must. Silas! Yes, of course, I do remember a childhood friend by that name. Wow, Mangs is such a good friend, just forgets his friends.
Cheers, good guy Mangs over here.
One who helped me explore the outside of the walls that bound me. Yeah, that's it. What else? Only bits and pieces at the moment. But I have a proposal for you. You say you would sacrifice your own life for mine? Indeed. Very well, then join forces with me. Yes! I know you're a knight of Nohr, and you may not believe in what I'm about to say, but King Aaron's gone absolutely mad. He gave me a cursed sword and sent me off to be captured by the Hoshidians, knowing, of course, that I would be brought before my mother. She was killed when the sword exploded. I would have been too. I don't believe it. So part of this grand plan to escalate the conflict into a full-blown war. I can't forgive his actions against Hoshido, and I will never return to Nohr. You must think I'm manipulating you. No, Mangs, I believe you. You spared my life twice now. I have no reason to doubt your story. Then will you join us? Yes, perhaps. What? What? You get Silas?
Yeah, you get Silas.
What? Yes! Yeah,
he's a character that enjoys you in both routes.
Oh my god! Oh, I'm so happy, Ray.
You do get a few of these characters that join you in both routes.
Silas! Woohoo! Yes, perhaps together we can bring peace to this world someday. That is my aim, Silas. I promise that I will never deviate from that course. I can't believe this is happening.
Max can't believe this is happening.
But the way you... Oh, hello, you little fucker. I love you. But the way you reacted when I asked you, it was... You kind of went sad. I think that was on purpose to fool me.
That was on purpose. That was worth it. Yes!
Lady Sakura, we got bad news.
This is an emergency. Hello there. Saisu, Orochi, what happened to you? You're both wounded. Our wounds are nothing but as far as Lord Ryoma and Lord Takumi. What? What happened to them? They're missing. Last anyone saw them, they were headed to Isuma. It's possible they were captured and wrapped.
Oh, my capture? Don't give me that.
I hate to think of the alternative. No. Lady Sakura, please take a deep breath. Saiso, Orochi, please tell me you're joking.
Yes, I'm well known for my japes, aren't I? I blame myself. I should have been at Lord Ryoma's side every step of the way.
Pardon me, but you must be Lord Mangs, yes? I'm Orochi. I used to serve as a diviner for Lady Mikoto. It seems
it would serve a common purpose for our armies to join forces. Our tactician, Yukimura, is readying the troops to march to Izumo. Time is of the essence. Will you join us in search for Lord Ryoma and Lord Takumi?
Yes, of course. We'll support you in any way that we can.
Thank you, Lord Mangs. I'm coming with you.
Lady Sakura, I strongly recommend that you can reconsider. The battlefield near the border is highly dangerous and
I don't care. I can't just stay here and do nothing. If there's anything I can do to help my brothers, I need to be in a position to do it.
I'm so sorry, Sakura, but I'm afraid I agree with Kasa.
Mangs, Sakura just lost her mother, and now her brothers are missing. It's understandable that she would want to accompany us. With my help, I believe we can provide adequate protection.
Yeah, Aqua, you're so good at protecting people. Actually, she kind of is now. Very well. I won't try to stop you, Sakura. I just hope you understand the risks.
Thank you, Mangs. I do.
Will you be joining us as well, Silas?
Yes, I will join you.
Although I must say that I didn't expect to be pressed into service this quickly.
You can't be serious, Mangs. You really allow this backstabbing Norian scum,
twice.
To accompany us.
This is not your call, Saiso. And besides, if we abandon him here, he dies. This is not the Hoshidian way.
Is the Hoshidian way to allow a potential spy access to our party? But I will follow Mang's lead for now, but I will keep my eyes wide open.
Saiso? Brother, Mang spared my life when I was a prisoner in Nohr. I assure you that we can trust his judgment.
Oh please, a five-year-old wouldn't be fooled by such an obvious setup.
I appreciate your skepticism, Saiso. I just hope you'll give me a chance to prove you wrong.
Words mean little. Actions are what count. We'll see what happens.
Mangs, we really must press on. Every second counts. Right, let's get moving.
Hey, hey. All right. So yeah, right. Me and Gast, we had this tradition where we talked a little bit about the map. So would you do me the honor?
Yes, of course.
Would you do me the honor of tell me what you thought about Chapter 7, the first chapter in Hoshido.
When I first played Chapter 7, I thought it was a pretty simple map, but I thought the premise was really silly. The whole the Norians attacking immediately after we were just trying to get on. I was like, oh, this is nice. You get some world building. Like, nope, can't have your world building just yet. We gotta get interrupted. And then Corrin and Silas shouting back and forth before the map even starts. Like, okay, that put me right off. Because I was still in the bitter mood of the start of the game. The start of the game really didn't leave a good taste in my mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So I was just like, this is not looking good for me. But the map itself, I thought was okay, just a bit choke point heavy. And as we can see here in Lunatic, it's a lot choke point heavy.
Yeah.
Even with Meng's much better units, he had a much better start than I did. But yeah, the whole it was really choke point heavy. But although on the whole, it wasn't that bad of a map, I thought.
The thief was a nice touch. He could have come a lot sooner, actually. But yeah, I do appreciate the fact that. I am very aware of the fact that I have really strong units. I'm not gonna hamper the difficulty too much. I know that I have access to ridiculous items due to like a million people visiting my castles, and I am aware of this. So I won't have. I did a good time, but the map design, they could have made it less choky. They could have been more paths to take. This chapter really needed alternate paths. Because there was really only one way to go.
The cardinal sin of a Mangs indoor map is to have only one path.
Yeah, yeah. Unlike, you know, Fates that pride itself on having multiple paths. Not so for the chapter! Or maybe I have to buy Revelations to unlock more paths. Da 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 da. With that pun, we shall end this part right here. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Ray, what do they have to do?
Please leave a like and a comment for this video, because it really helps Mank's channel a lot, don't you know?
I missed that, Ray. And yeah, go subscribe to Ray's channel as well, because he also does Fire Emblem. But you probably already knew that, since like all of my fans came from your channel at some point. So, until next time, guys. My name has been Mangs.
I've been Ray.
And we shall see you guys next time. Goodbye!
Later.